I just retired my compact keyboard as a daily driver, and this showed up a day later in a dumpster. Is this a sign? It is a compact Armada 7710 MT laptop. So let's check out in this video if this laptop still works. The laptop is in a really decent shape. It's not yellowed. Nothing is broken off. It's a little bit dirty. Let's check what we have. If we open the screen, we see immediately it's an Intel Pentium MMX. We have speakers here, a microphone, a decent size screen, a nicely feeling keyboard, and here is the mouse pointer, power button, volume button, some extra buttons. And here we have a sticker in Dutch, so it's probably just sold here in the Netherlands. If we take a look at the back, we have a COM port, parallel port, a port to the docking station, PS2, VGA, and it has a built-in power supply, which I really love on laptops. Here has an infrared port and an audio port. Here on the side we have PCMCA slots, and we have two cards in it. So let's find out what it is. It's a Sweex 100 Mbit network adapter and a Sweex wireless 11 Mbit adapter. And here we have a strange port with contact pins, which I don't know what it is. On the front we have a CD-ROM player. Here goes the hard drive. This is the battery, and this is probably the fan. And a nice detail is we have little stands here, so we can set the laptop in an angle. Here on the bottom it says it's a product of the UK. The series is 2890A, and it accepts 100 to 120 volt and 220 to 240 volt. We can use it in the US and here in Europe. And here's a configuration ID sticker from the shop that it sold, but it's broken off. Here the rubber feet are missing, there's some tape over it, and it's really dirty, so I need to clean this up. Behind this door there's the memory. One thing that is missing on this laptop is a floppy drive. That is pretty strange, because normally a laptop from this era has a floppy drive. And also this laptop has no USB ports. But it's a really cool find, and it's pretty heavy. With this switch we can remove the CD-ROM player. So it is on a module, and with this switch we can remove the hard drive. And the hard drive is 1.6 gigabyte, and with this switch we can remove the battery. And the battery is 14.4 volt and 2.7 ampere hour, and it has not been leaking or bulging. But it is probably dead. We have some status lights here, so let's try it. And nothing, but maybe if we power it up it will charge a bit. The laptop looks in a really decent state, so let's find a power cable and try it out. So let's see, this normal power connectors. I think I found it. Let's power it up and see if it's still working. Okay, the LED is turning on here, so let's try it out. Oh, it has 80 megabytes of memory, so the memory is already upgraded. That's a lot of memory for a laptop like this. Oh no, we have Windows Millennium. But at least they didn't install Windows XP on it. I really like this screen. It's really bright and good viewing angle, so this is really usable. And we have Roller Coaster Tycoon installed, WinZip, Windows Media Player, Real Player. Some documents are still on here, so they didn't delete anything. Cool, it already found my Wi-Fi network, so the Wi-Fi is working. And we have MSN Messenger! Oh, I'm gonna blur out this name. Let's see. Yeah, the original hard drive is still in here, because it's showing 1.5 gigabyte. In the My Documents we have a map drivers, learning tasks. It's probably used by a teacher. There's not much data on this system. We have a map music, but also like empty. And some other documents which I don't gonna read.
And indeed, we have 80 megabytes of memory. Yes, that is great, because now we can really do something with this laptop. We have an S3 Aurora 64V+ video card, so probably no real 3D support. We have an ES1878 audio interface. It says that it has a modem, and there was a blanked off modem port in the back, so not sure if it's really working or not. Infrared, a compact CD-ROM. So it's pretty original, this system. The network adapters are installed. I like this laptop. I like this laptop a lot. Let's see if there's any special programs installed. Not much. What's this? Fatal Illusion? Cluedo? I never heard of this. New game. Oh, we need a disc. Please tell me, what is Fatal Illusion for a game? Because I don't know it. Probably Roller Coaster Tycoon also needs a CD-ROM. But we can try, maybe it's a cracked version. Oh, no disc. Normally I don't get excited about old laptops, but this one, I quite like it. Because it has a really good screen, it has a built-in power supply, it comes with network cards, the only thing it's missing is a floppy drive, but it looks in a good shape. I need to clean it, but it looks like everything is working, like the sound and... But let's find out some more specs and what kind of CPU we have. So let's connect to the network and see if that will work. Okay, my network locations. And the machine is quite reactive, so it's not a slow machine. Let's see if this will work. Yeah, it found my file server already on the network. CPU set. Let's copy it. And I found an updated CPU set, which also has Windows 98 support. So let's find out the specs of this machine. Okay, we have an Intel Pentium MMX and P55C, and it's running at 150 megahertz. We have a 16 kilobyte level 1 cache. It's not showing level 2 cache, but this machine is so responsive, so it probably has some level 2 cache. Compact motherboard, 80 megabytes of memory. The graphics card is an S3 Aurora 64. So this laptop is a really awesome find. I mean, a Pentium 150 MMX with 80 megabytes of memory and a 1.6 gigabyte hard drive with Wi-Fi and Ethernet. It's just a really awesome configuration. But I don't think Windows ME is the best operating system for a laptop like this. But it is really responsive. So I think Windows 95 or Windows 98 or maybe Windows NT 4.0 is a better choice for this laptop. Probably gonna reinstall it, maybe upgrade the hard drive, maybe find a Tricom PCMCIA network card. Maybe even more memory, I'm not sure yet. We should check out how much memory can go in this machine. I think I have a new retro laptop that I gonna use, because the screen is really nice and bright. Even the viewing angles here are awesome. This was probably a really expensive laptop back in the days. Let's find out three things about this laptop. Let's see if there's some life left in the battery. Let's see if it has CD-ROM boot support. And let's see what the memory configuration is. Let's first test the battery. This light is that the battery is charging. So let's remove the power cable. Okay, the battery is probably dead. But what do you expect of a laptop of 23 years old? Come on, CD-ROM player. Ah, nice. Let's try this original Windows 95 CD-ROM. Was it F10 or F1 or delete, escape, F12, F11? Yes, we are in the compact utilities and we have not a mouse pointer. Okay. Okay, the computer setup looks amazing. It's really graphical. Okay, the system information, an Armada 7710MT Intel Pentium MX 150. and it's June or March 99, so it's not that old. Maybe the BIOS is updated then, I'm not sure. Okay, the system date is 1980, so it's probably an empty battery. Power management, security, boot management. It has a floppy controller, but it doesn't have the floppy drive with it. Resources, boot management, IDE controller, hard drive. You can only manage the diagnostic partition when booting from a diagnostic diskette. And I don't have a diskette drive. Or the diskette. Okay, let's try the Windows NT 4 CD instead of the Windows 95 CD. Because I'm not sure if the Windows 95 CD is bootable from CD-ROM. Yes, Windows NT setup! It's booting from CD-ROM! Yes! Okay, we know that the machine is booting from CD-ROM, so we don't actually need a floppy drive to reinstall this one. So let's check out the memory support. So the machine has 80 megabytes of memory, so it has probably 60 megabyte memory and a 64 megabyte module, or maybe onboard memory and two modules. I'm not sure, but here's the memory location, so let's open it and see what kind of configuration we have. Okay, we have an 8-ohm module, but only one module. So let's see what happens when we remove this one, because I think that this is a 64 megabyte memory module. And it is a compact branded module. So this is nice to have in the system. So let's power it up without this module and see how much it will display. Maybe the memory door needs to be closed, because there are some metal strips here, so it's still compact, so they do weird stuff. Okay, it doesn't give a display without this module, so I'm not sure what's going on. The memory is showing 80 megabytes again. I have some random memory modules here, so let's see if we can upgrade this memory even more. Okay, we have here a PC100 module, and this is an 8-ohm module. Physically fits. Not sure if this is the correct one. This is a video card upgrade module. DDR, that's not gonna work. Another PC100 module. A compact module with no information. But it fits. Another module that fits, but with no information. I think I'm gonna Google what the memory specifications are, because I'm not sure what will happen if I put PC100 in it. Okay, I checked online. The system has 60 megabyte memory on board, and this is a 64 megabyte module, and the maximum memory support is 144 megabyte. So I need a second EDO 64 megabyte module. And this is all PC100 or PC66, so I don't even gonna try it. I probably gonna see if I can find another module, or maybe buy it on eBay. But 80 megabyte for Windows 95, 98 or NT4 is more than enough. So let's try to clean the laptop, because there is some dirt on it. Oh, that makes it much, much nicer already. I probably need to clean this with a lot of benzene instead of window cleaner. Yeah, this will work, but paper is probably not the best thing. Yeah, this will work. Thanks for watching. Please like and share this video, subscribe and leave a comment. You can join Retro Machines on Facebook and support me monthly on Patreon. And if you want to help me out on my channel, you can use my Amazon affiliated links.